My lords, on the 5th of November, London bus drivers marched on Westminster to complain about their working conditions, including the fact that most routes now only have toilet facilities at one end, meaning that the drivers have 3 hours between toilet breaks. The fact that the headway driving system sometimes requires drivers to break the speed limit, and conditions within cabs can become unbearably hot or unbearably cold. In all this talk about funding, could the Minister, the Noble Lord, the Minister, assure us that drivers will not be forgotten in all this?
The Noble Lord might know that for some years I was responsible for the London bus service. I'm not any longer. The Mayor of London is. But I would question some of the things that he's asserted, simply because through prior knowledge, we spent an awful lot of time and money providing far more toilet facilities for bus drivers in London than anybody had ever done before. I would be very questionable that any responsible licensed operator by the traffic commissioners would commission schedules which expected buses to exceed the speed limit. But what I would say to him is that it is very important that bus drivers are paid properly, are looked after properly, that their scheduled hours and their actual hours comply with the law. And to that end, the Driver and Vehicle Services Agency will inspect those operations, whether they're in London or elsewhere, and the traffic commissioners will take action for operators who don't comply with the legislation in respect to the operation of urban bus services.